Hello, today we are looking at Linux Mint 18.3 XFCE Beta. It has been released a few days ago, but it's not yet on the official site, not yet official release, but it was approved for stable, not for beta, about 2 days ago on the official site, as well as then about 3-4 hours later, it came in the repos. It's fantastic. So if you click on apps, otherwise the welcome app is still the same, mostly links with some new features, and yeah, but it's basically still the same except for the software center. As you can see, it looks brand new, and it's not just one view. They changed this picture. If he closes and opens it up again, Firefox won't be the main one anymore, hopefully. Yeah, as you can see, and what is unique about, what is different about this release of the software center is there's many new apps, like WhatsApp is here, and the big one is Flatpak has been added to this release. So you have all your many Flatpak apps here, which you can install straight from the welcoming app, as well as editor speaks. So you can see what the editor suggests to install, and there's some really cool apps inside here. And when you type in the search button, let's say Steam, for example, you will see there's two versions of Steam, the Flatpak version and the default normal version. So if Flatpak doesn't work for you yet, just use the normal one. It's like in the making of something great. And but some of them is not. If you go to Skype, for example, oh no, it is flat up. I saw it once that Skype was not written Flatpak also, so it's great, it's been fixed. So yes, the rest in this welcome app is still the same. If you go to the menu, still the Whisker menu, it's still the familiar, beloved XFCE stuff. They didn't go do some crazy changes. I love, as always, if you go to like appearances, it's not a normal XFCE release. It's all the Mint layouts is also here, as well as in the normal XFCE ones. It's, as always, there's a lot of options by XFCE, and that's what I love. I love dark themes, and this dark theme looks absolutely beautiful. And want to look at the backup tool. It's a fantastic tool which is new, which has been updated in this release of Linux Mint. It is fantastic to make snapshots like you have in Windows, where you can return to if you mess your computer up or if you've done something, or you can just make like a snapshot before you do something, and then you can always return back to it, and then you can restore it, you can set it up with a schedule, same with apps, and then you can also make a backup of your old system and save it to a different drive, and when it breaks you can just return it as to what you want it to be. So it's fantastic, it's a great addition. I just want to go back to the settings because I don't like my top bar. I think it is somewhere, I think it's here. Can't really remember, and I feel like a fool right now. But, don't you just love it? Oh, there we go. Let's go for dark, much better. Yeah, and basically, oh, they got new wallpapers also, and I once heard, and I loved the phrase that was once used about Linux Mint and its wallpapers. It's like postcards, because it is as beautiful as postcards, and what the XFCE version does, they put all the wallpapers of the 18.x series together, and as 18.3 is the last of the 18.x version, you got a lot of choices, and that's amazing. And this is the last of the 18.x releases, which is based on Ubuntu 16.4, which is supported until April 2021. And so the long term, and the next release will be, I believe, Linux Mint 19 and based on Ubuntu 18.4. So that will be so exciting and exciting to see. So in general, thumbs up, very smooth, very quick. Some, not many new features, but it's just a nice stable release and absolutely worth checking out. Yeah. On kernel version, let's quickly have a look. Is 4.10, so it's still the same as Ubuntu 16.4 and what it has been. So yeah, thank you for watching. See you later. Goodbye, and if you like it, use it. And this is just a beta and it feels like a stable, so yeah, see you later. Goodbye.